Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. So this is pick a card reading, and excuse the nails, I just couldn't be bothered to do them, they're all broken and what have you. So yeah, so this is pick a pile on what's their karma for hurting you. I haven't done it in a while, so let's pick a card really. Ignore the stones, I just put them on there for the photo. I don't even know what the stones are, I've forgotten the names of them, so I'm just gonna just ignore that, you didn't see that. So pile one, well, card one is a consciousness of lack. So this is all about consciousness. So I've got another consciousness card, dark thoughts. And then we have for card three, we have milestone. So these are events, things that took place. So I'll let you choose your card and I'll see you at that card. Hey, card one. So if you chose this card, person that you're dealing with, this energy that I'm picking up on, they literally thought more of, you know, money, material things. That's the word that I'm thinking of. Material things were more important than love, because if you actually look at this card, you've got the heart there. You've got, inside the heart, you've got coins. So this energy here that I've picked, like the card that you've picked, is someone that put material wealth or material success above love and maybe your relationship or your friendship or whatever it was. And no matter how much they had, they just are never satisfied. Look at the way this person's moping at the side there. And it's like they didn't have a clue as maybe as to why maybe things may have ended with you, or why you don't communicate with them no more, or why things went wrong. It's like they just don't get it, basically. So let's get your tarot cards and find out more about this. Let's use these ones. So spirit, angels, ancestors, tell me about pile ones. What's the karma for this person that hurt my pile one? Tell me more about the consciousness of lack. Oh, dear. Okay. The moon. Right. This makes sense for me, basically. So what I'm seeing from this card of the Nine of Swords is that basically whatever, ignore me please. So right, get your head on. Picking up confusion with this pile really, it's like I want to get my words out but I'm just like stumbling over my words. I mean, usually you can't shut me up. Right, so anyway, this person, I don't know, or energy, let's say energy. Whatever happened to them in the past, maybe they suffered, you know, they grew up in poverty, is what I'm trying to get at. Maybe they grew up with lack of material things, lack of clothes, lack of money, lack of food. That's what I'm picking up from this energy here. So they put wealth above everything else, including you, my collective, my pole ones. So, you know, they would stay up late at night and worry, is it enough? Is it enough? No, I need more. I need more. So I'm picking up greed here. They've let their greed, they've let their past turn them greedy, is what I'm picking up. So you would have this person sitting up all night, you know, worrying about their finances, you know, where's the next coin coming from, basically. So let's have a look more. So I want to get the energy of the person first, you know, and then I'll go into the karma of it. Maybe I should have said that first. Don't forget, these are energies as well. So you could be male or female, anybody, the Queen of Swords, blah, blah, blah. We know how that works, don't we? If you've been here regularly. If you're a newbie, that's how it works. So tell me more about this Nine of Swords and the consciousness of lack, please, spirit. The Star, the Nine of Wands. Yeah, see, they wanted all their dreams to come true. This is Aquarius energy, by the way. They wanted their, you know, they have everything. that they want, but I'm getting it's just not enough. They want to reach higher and higher. You know, there's nothing wrong with that, but they're neglecting the people that's around them. You know, they carry this around with them. This is a chip on their shoulder that they've been carrying around with them for a very long time. It's like it's from their childhood. You know, that's what I'm picking up. So it's like this chip that they just will not let go. And it causes them worry and stress that they just don't have enough. Tell me a bit more about this energy, spirit. And so what I'm getting is just, you know, who is this person to my pile ones? Who is this energy here to my pile? Oh, gold. That just flew out. Three of Pentacles, Nine of Cups, Page of Pentacles. So for some of you, it can be a friend. For some of you, it can be someone you worked with that you built up a really good friendship with them. For some of you, it can be, because I'm looking at different scenarios here. For some of you, it can be that you may have started a business with this person and they became greedy, you see. Because the Nine of Cups is the wish card. It is fulfillment. It is success. Now, yes, this brought success, but also it brings along greed. I see this as a greedy card as well. So whoever this person was became greedy, which has already been clarified in those cards there. So yeah, you're dealing with someone that it could be like a work friend, you know, business partner. We have the Page of Pentacles here, which is Earth sign Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Now the Page of Pentacles is, I feel like this is you guys. Because the Page of Pentacles is someone that is very loyal and dependable. I mean, it can be this energy here as well. You know, they're loyal, they're dependable, you know, and so I do feel like they are loyal, they are dependable, but what went wrong? What happened? All right, we've said, you know, I've said that the person became greedy. Tell me more. What happened here? What did they do, spirit? Tell us more. Seven of Wands, Knight of Swords. Okay. Oh, Ten of Wands in reverse. They did something, they brought a big change into whatever it was here, a big, big change. And it disrupted everything. This is someone that could be very impulsive, someone that jumps in, doesn't think about the consequences. So it could be that they lost their money, you know, they made you lose money as well, or clients, or, you know, whatever it was that happened. And the thing was, you tried to talk to them about this, pile one. You try to tell them that this is not a good idea, but they were standing their ground on this. They would not budge. They were being stubborn about this, you know. And yes, it brought a lot of burdens and a lot of worries. It caused a lot of worries for you. But what's happening here now for you, pile one, you're actually letting those worries and burdens go. It's like you're done with it. You're like, you know, letting it go, it is what it is. Yes, you got hurt in the process, but I want to let it go, which is really good. So what else for pile one? Spirit, what else? Oh, Seven of Swords, happy days, the Tower, Eight of Swords, right. This makes sense. I'm taking this as well. Now, what I'm seeing here is that they brought about a big change in your life, and you know, it caused a big disruption. There was a lot of lies that went with this, and truth started to come out, and like I said, where they stood their ground and they were being stubborn about this, it caused a Tower moment in your life, in their life as well. And I'm picking up, I feel like they lost a lot here. Now they're in the Eight of Swords mind of feeling trapped, not knowing how to get out of this situation. It's like they're stuck now. They're stuck in this and they have to face it now. And the reason being is because they were so sneaky about doing this. They used underhanded methods, basically. So, you know, the Seven of Swords is someone that cheats, lies, steals, you know, tries to get away with something. So maybe they stole something, they lied about something. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Tell me about the Seven of Swords. Tell me about the Seven of Swords, please, Spirit. Sun, Justice, there's the Karma card, and the Knight of Swords again. So, where they went around being sneaky and doing these underhanded methods and what have you, they thought it was going to bring a lot of happiness, you know. You know, this could have even happened in the summertime, you know, summer that just gone. I mean, I'm here in the UK, so I don't know where you guys are. You might be summer now, so this could be happening now for some of you. But this was brought to light for you. You found out a lot of things about this person that I think you were so devastated that you couldn't believe that this person was like this, because you, I've got a feeling you put them on a pedestal. Justice, Karma, Libra card here as well. This is fairness at the end of the day, because I think this person got so overwhelmed with greed, you know, because of obviously what's happened to them. They got so greedy that karma's now coming and giving them a bit of a whooping here. That it's not all about material wealth, basically. And the Justice card as well, it's about you deciding whether, you know, you want to forgive this person or not, whether you want to just leave it in the past, you know, that it's your choice. You don't have to forgive this person if you don't want to. But I'm picking up they abused your trust, Power One. And here we go again, the Knight of Swords. The Knight of Swords is someone that is a big risk taker, someone that jumps in, doesn't think before they act, you know, they just was impulsive when it came to this. So, right, we've got the overall energy of this person here, or this energy here. So now tell me about the karma for this person, please, Spirit. Tell me what's their karma. What is their karma, Spirit? What is their karma? See, I'm not picking up that there's really a lot of karma for this person, to be honest. Not too much. I just think, you know, in a way, I actually feel very sorry for this energy here, Pile One. I do. I feel, you know, I grew up poor. Yeah, I don't actually put material wealth above anything else. It's never really bothered me, money, as long as I can feed myself and my children. I appreciate family more and love, you know, those kind of things, than having money in your pocket. I know that sounds really sad. Most probably some of you are thinking, you freaking liar, but no, I'm being serious. But yeah, I do really feel sorry for this energy here, in a way, to grow up like that and become so obsessed. That's what I'm picking up, obsessive energy here that's needs more, needs more, needs more. It's not enough. Eight of Wands, Six of Cups, Two of Pentacles, Five of Swords, Ten of Swords, Ten of Pentacles. So the karma for this person here is that, on the back of the deck, the energy is the Hermit. The energy of the Hermit for the karma for this person is like, it's like becoming a social outcast, basically. It's like people don't want to be associated with this person anymore. people gossiping about this person now, you know, sharing information about what went wrong. So it could be in the business world, you know, whatever they've had going for them, is not to trust this person. So this is part of their karma for being greedy. Now, the Eight of Wands is all about messages and communication. So the communication here is they're waiting for some kind of news. And it's all about Six of Cups. It's someone from the past. It's a reconciliation here. So it could be from you guys, my pile one. It could be that they're desperately waiting to hear from you, desperately waiting for you to come back. But the karma is here is I feel you are not going to reach out to this person. This is part of their karma. This is part of their lessons here. You know, karma is karma. We don't wish bad karma on no one. You know, we've all got to deal with our karma here. So I don't take no satisfaction in doing these readings or anything like that, and I actually do feel really sorry for this energy, really, to be honest. Like I've already said, picking up sadness here, and I think you guys, maybe that's what I'm picking up, that you feel sad for this person, you know. So anyway, babbling. So they're waiting to hear from you, and I feel like there will no, you know, with the karma, there's not going to be a reconciliation for you both. I think you just want to just leave it in the past. You're done with it. The Two of Pentacles here, you know, now you're at the stage of having to juggle your finances and put your life back together, because they put this, you know, they put you in this position now is why you don't want to reconcile with this person. Their karma at the moment is their finances, their life at the moment is so unbalanced. It's like they can't seem to get it to balance out. Again, they're trying really hard, but, you know, they've got to learn their lessons. You know, Five of Swords, karma here is they, you know they're defeated in this. They know they messed up. You know, this is people that have walked away from them. They've lost connections. They've lost you. They've lost, you know, good friends. Ten of Swords, karma is now of constantly feeling guilty, you know, remorse, you know, this haunts them all the time, that basically they know they stabbed a lot of people in the back. They know they caused the ultimate betrayal towards you and other people. And now they're left in this, you know, depressed stage, the grieving stage as well. And it plays on their mind all the time, you know, then this guilt, this constantly being reminded of what they did is part of their karma as well. Ten of Pentacles, generational wealth. Now, this is so sad. I just feel so sad for this person. They built up a company, you know, material wealth, which was the Ten of Pentacles. And this is the most valuable card in the deck here. This is generational wealth, where you pass your wealth on to your children, and then they pass it on to their children. And they had this. They had this generational wealth, and because of their greed, they lost this generational wealth. There is no wealth, you know, to hand down to their children and their children's children. It's not there no more. Karma's taken it away, because I think their spirit guides want them to learn that it's not all about wealth, money, the good things in life. Love is what's important. Respect is what's important. You know, looking after the people around you is what's important. Respecting other people, you know, and this is what this person is just lacking. They lack that side of them. And it's just so sad. Very sad. So let's get my karma cards. I really need to get these turned into cards. I haven't done them yet. I'm being lazy. So spirit, what's their karma for hurting my part ones? So I feel like you guys lost a lot as well. I feel like this went so bad, like the tower moment here. Like you lost everything. Everything that you worked hard for here, my part one. And now I can't breathe. People will talk shite about them. This is what I said about the hermit. People are gossiping behind their back. They're talking about what they did. Then we've got will not be able to find a job. There you go. People do not want to work with them no more because of the risk that they took, the backstabbing that they caused with the Seven of Swords here. Someone close was still your man or woman. So maybe they were in a relationship and the person decided that you can't financially support me no more, so I'm off with whoever can, you know. I'm picking up that this what I'm picking up as well with this energy here is they have a lot of shallow people in their energy, you know. They deal with people that don't have a heart, you know, or a good soul or a good aura or energy. They deal with people that work at lower vibration, whereas you are not like that. You are someone that is very loyal and trusting, you know. So what else, Spirit? What's their karma for hurting my power ones? It's all about work here. This is how they would be fired from their job. Maybe there was some fraud in a company here that they did, that they got fired from it. Goes deeper than what I'm seeing here, but obviously I'd be here all day. So what's their karma, Spirit? Let's take those ones. On the back of the deck, the karma is they will lose their home. Obviously, if they've lost their money, they can't afford to pay for where they are. If they've got some big fancy house, they have to downgrade. And I think this is what the lessons are from, you know, their karmic lessons are. I mean, it's funny how the Justice card came out in this reading. Their lessons are, is you may have to go back to basics. Learn to appreciate the people and the things around you. We've got all their secrets will be exposed is what I've got. Their secret with the hermit is like basically people gossiping, people telling their secrets. We'll not be able to manifest anything. Yeah, he or she is on block at the moment until their karmic dues are being paid, basically, pile one. So I'm going to leave it there. If you like this video, please hit like. And I'll see you soon. Bye. Hey, pile, I was gonna say one, two. So this is your reading. You chose dark thoughts. Now, the energy of this person, because I'm gonna look into the energy of the person first before I find out their karma. I don't actually like this energy, to be honest. But this is what came out for pile two. This is someone that has a dark soul, not someone. It reminds me of the devil card here, someone that is very toxic, someone that plays mind games with you, pile two, you know, confuses your mind. Basically, you don't know whether you're coming and going. You could be dealing with someone that gaslights you, someone that is a narcissist, someone that is abusive. So if this trigger, you know, trigger warning here, if you know it's too much for you, don't watch this, please. So yeah, this is someone that is very dark. I'm just picking up not nice, not nice. That's all I keep hearing. Tell me more about these dark thoughts, please, Spirit. Tell me more, please. Tell me more about these dark thoughts. Death in reverse. Right, we've got Ace of Emotions. The overall energy of this person is that either my pile two, you've walked away from them, okay? That's leaving a long-term relationship behind, leaving someone behind that doesn't, you know, doesn't serve you anymore, doesn't do good for your health, you know, emotionally. Or it could be that you're wanting to leave this person, but you just don't know how to do it, you know. But what I'm picking up here is that I feel like my pile twos, you've not actually done it. I feel like you're trapped. I feel like this person may be financially abusing you as well, because with the death in reverse, it's you know, an ending. It's leaving something behind that doesn't serve you anymore. You know, it's moving on, but where it's in reverse, it's like things are changing for the worse. Basically, you're in a bad situation here, and it's like you can't get out because of financial reasons, maybe. And I feel like you've got children with this person as well, pile two. This is really deep. I feel really drained, and I've only just started this pile. So yeah, I feel like you've got children with this person, or for some of you, you could be pregnant, or they could have trapped you and got you pregnant, is what I'm picking up as well. You know, and if you're a man, you can reverse that as well. So, you know, they tricked you into getting them pregnant. You know, I'm on the pill, blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? Okay. But I feel like you do know what this person is all about, because the sun's all about, you know, having that epiphany moment or shining a light on what the problem is. You do know, you're not stupid, pile two. You do know what the problem is, but it's like you're stuck. You're stuck in this situation. Six of materials is equal give and take, but there's no equal give and take with this person. They tell you when you can have something, you know. They control your finances. They control your movements, is what I'm picking up. Got Scorpio energy here as well, guys. With the Ace of Pentacles, you know, this is all about, I feel like this is you guys, you know, Spirit is saying that you can have a new beginning, you can start again. There is a new beginning for you if that's what you want, you know, financial stability, a new job, moving home, starting again. You know, this is there for you. And for my pile twos here, I feel like you do really want to walk away from this person. But, and like I said, for some of you, take what resonates, you have already walked away. But, and another scenario I'm picking up here as well, guys, is that if for some of you that you have walked away, you're actually in a worse position than you was, because they're still controlling that help, that financial support that you know that you need if you've got children and what have you. So I still feel like this person is still controlling the, you know, the situation here. Good, horrible energy. Honestly, awful. Tell me more, Spirit, please. Tell me more about this death in reverse. I never had the death in reverse in any of my readings, actually. Tell me about the death in reverse. About death in reverse, please. So we have Nine of Emotions, which is Nine of Cups, Page of Cups. This is the Ace of Swords, Seven of Pentacles, and Four of Pentacles. You know, for you, like, to talking about the death in reverse, for you, you know, you saw this person as your wishes coming true, but then in reality, it really wasn't something that was, you know, you got this wish that of something that you wanted so much, but you ended up with someone that was the Page of Swords. This is the Page of Cups, sorry. This is somebody that is very manipulative, very childish, very immature as well. So they can be older. It's just that they just are just immature. They emotionally stunted is what I'm getting here. It's like if they don't get their own way, they'll have a paddy. And I do feel like they lash out verbally, you know, in an abusive way. And the promises that they gave you when you met this person, you thought you were getting all your dreams were coming true. But what you were actually getting were empty promises, basically. Look at the hole in the stomach here. And this is a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, that we've got here, guys. Now, yeah, they don't handle things very well. You know, they may be older, but they're still very young and dumb, as we say over here. So the Ace of Swords is truth and clarity. The truth finally came out, you know. The truth was revealed to you of how, you know, how this person actually was. The truth was revealed that they weren't willing to be this partner that you thought you were getting when you got with them. And also when the Ace of Swords comes out, it's spirit saying that what the reader is saying is the truth. You know, the truth was revealed to you that you got yourself into a sticky situation. Seven of Pentacles is someone that is having to work hard, skimp and scrape. You know, for some of you, like I said, maybe some of you are actually sneakily putting money away to maybe try and get out of this situation. You know, you're trying to save every little bit of money that they give you. But you are trying really hard to leave this situation here. And the Four of Pentacles is someone that will not let you go. Someone that will hold on to you and they control you. Like I said, because this is finances. All I keep hearing is finances. They control you by, you know, maybe your stay-at-home parent. But they are very possessive over you as well. I'm surprised the Devil card hasn't come out, honestly. They're very possessive over you. It's like they just do not want to let you go. It's like you are a possession to them. And I'm getting angry. Tell me about the Ace of Swords, please, Spirit. Actually, no. No, no. Tell me about the Page of Emotions here. Find more about this energy here. Tell me about Page of Emotions. Yeah, look, they juggle that they... And this is what I love to see, the wheel. Wheel is all about karma, and we're doing a karma reading here. This is all about justice. This is all about fairness. This is about that justice is... Karma's about... To beat this person's ass. I wanted to swear, but you know, you can't swear too much on these things. So yeah, the wheel is about to turn here, and I see you sitting on top of the wheel. You're going to end up victorious, not this person. This person, they literally hold the key, the car, the they hold the what's the word? I'm trying to explain this. They hold the they have the power, that's the word. They have the power when it comes to finances and when they decide to give it to you, like I said, or, you know, this is a way of controlling you. So they balance, they have to, oh God, get it out. So they deal with all the finances and maybe the home life and paying the bills and things like that. That's their way of controlling you, you see. That's what I was trying to say. So tell us more about this situation. Tell me more about this situation for my pile twos. Temperance again, that's come out twice on the back of the deck. Six of Emotions. Six of Cups, Ten of Pentacles. Interesting. I like these three cards here. So, like, for some of you, like I said, if you've got children with this person, you know, Six of Cups is all about childhood friends or childhood sweethearts or children. It's also about reconciliation. I feel like you're going to reconcile. Someone's going to come to your aid here. Someone from your past that you may have known when you were children. This person comes from wealth, generational wealth. They've had, you know, they could have had their money handed down to them. But it's neither here nor there. They're a really good person. So I feel like they're going to come to your aid to help you here, to maybe get out of this situation. Maybe you've kept this to yourself that you've not spoken to anyone. And if that's the case, maybe you should open up and talk to someone about this. But this is someone that wants to help you. It's someone that is financially stable, someone that's doing so well with themselves. They've got a family. You know, they could have a family of their own. They could be married, this person that you know, but you've known them for a long time. And they're good people is what I'm picking up. Now, the world is all about endings, you know, closing a chapter. And I feel like this person's going to help you close this chapter in your life, you know, leave it all behind, which is going to restore inner peace and harmony. You know, this is going to put you back into alignment with yourself, pile two, once you leave this person, because you are out of whack at the moment. You know, the Two of Pentacles, as well as I see, you are so like not in sync. You're all over the place at the moment. You know, you've got the Star, which is we've got Sagittarius energy, we've got Aquarius energy here as well. So yeah, you've got this is like your dreams coming true, basically, the Star. You know, whatever you want in life, you can have. You know, you've got dreams, you've got things that you want to do with yourself, and Spirit is saying you can do this. Tell me about this six of emotions, Spirit. Let's get a bit more information on this energy here. Chariot, someone coming towards you to communicate. Someone moving towards you, you know, they could be coming in their car to talk to you, because this is forward movement. You've got the Five of Pentacles. I think this person's coming towards you because you are financially struggling at the moment. You are in poverty. You are being left out in the cold. You're being mistreated. You know, this is someone that is depressed, someone that is really struggling, and they don't want to see you like this, whoever this Six of Cups is. The Hermit. Two of Emotions, Two of Cups, the Lovers. Right, okay. So this could be someone, like I said, that you haven't seen in a very long time, that they went radio silent, you know, that you've not had any communication with them. For some of you, this can be a past lover. This can be someone that you had a relationship with, you know, and at one time it was a beautiful relationship. It could have even just been childhood sweethearts, you know, but it was two people that were in love, and they had this connection. So you've got the Two Emotions there, which is the soulmate card as well. So this can be your soulmate. You've got Lovers here. So the reason why I'm saying that this may have been a past love for you, that's coming to see you to help you, is because the Lovers is here, Gemini card as well. But it also could be that this is a choice that you need to make. You need to make the right choice for you, you know. Do I stay with this dark energy over here, or do I move forward with this person here that wants to help me? Tell me about the Lovers and the Two of Cups. I mean, like I said, this person could be married or they might not be married, but there is someone that wants to help you here, pile two. Tell me about Two of Emotions and Lovers here, please, Spirit. What did I say about the Devil? I said I'm surprised the Devil didn't come out. We've got the Devil, the Magician, Ten of Cups, Knight of Emotions, and the Wheel is out again. Now, this is the Lovers and Two of Cups. Okay, like the choice you have to make here. You have a choice between two people here, okay? Pile two. You know, and everybody has free will. You've got the Devil energy here. This is someone that is mind control, and that is what this card here is someone that controls the way you think, the way you feel, you know, like gaslighting. I think they're a big gaslighter here, guys. You know, they make you act to feel like you're crazy. You know, look at the maze in this card as well. I feel like this is your mind. Look at the clouds above it. You don't know whether you're coming or going is what I'm getting. So the devil is all about control. It's all about codependency. And I do feel like you are codependent on this energy here, guys, because they do control the finances here, you know, and that's not your fault. That is actual abuse. I'm not a doctor, just saying, but, you know, I think we've all been there, guys. So, you know, the devil is all about codependency, control. It can be someone that's addicted to drugs, even. It can be someone that's addicted to alcohol. But I'm not picking up so much that. I just feel like this person's energy is so dark. So dark. I don't actually like it. And I will be getting my cleansing stick out after I've done your reading and cleansing my freaking self. But the good thing here is the mask has slipped off with the magician. Yes, it's all, you know, it's manifestation and what have you. But I don't just see the magician as that. I see it as someone that is a brilliant manipulator. You know, they play games, they play, you know, they control the way you feel, the way you think. And this is what I'm on about, gaslighting here. And the mask is finally slipping off. You now see that this person is actually the devil. This is someone that is so low vibrational at the moment. And, well, at the moment, I think they've always been low vibrational, to be honest. And you're seeing them for who they are now. It could even be that your mask has finally come, you know, your rose-coloured, you know, your rose-coloured goggles, as they say, has finally dropped off, that you're actually seeing this person for who they are. Now, the Ten of Emotions is all about the Ten of Cups. It's all about love. It's all about happy ever after. You've got the Ten of Pentacles there with the Ten of Cups here. Now, this is someone, because I wanted to clarify the Two of Cups and the Lovers here, that wants to have this with you, that really does feel some really strong love for you, you know, and they want to offer that to you. It's starting a family, it's moving in together, it's starting a life together, building a life together. And this is someone that is, you know, water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. We have the Knight of Emotions. This is someone that is someone that's very romantic at heart and very charming, you know, sincere and loyal they are. And they've got this proposal for you. So they're going to come and talk to you about this, you know, put this to you and, you know, maybe offer to help you. And this is where I said before that this is you now. You sitting on top of the wheel. Things are starting to change. It's now it's your turn to, you know, sit up there and not be down here anymore. This is karmic justice is what I'm seeing here for you because of what you've gone through with this energy here. So let's find out their karma for what they, you know, for all this, because this is not nice. What is the karma for this energy here, spirit, for hurting my pole toes? What is the karma for this energy here? What is their karma? That came out like that. The Fool is new beginnings, you know, taking a leap of faith, starting again. So maybe they feel like, oh, well, you know, you're gone, I can start again. But because it came out like this, and this is their karma, this is someone that weren't prepared for you leaving them. This is someone that was very big-headed, thinking that you're never going to leave them and start again, you know, and move on and blah, blah, blah. And they're going to be feeling stuck. They're going to feel like they can't move on from you, because I do feel like you are going to haunt them. So what's their karma for hurting? So we have the Ace of Wands. So if they think that they're going to get a passionate new beginning. I mean, the Fool's on the side there. You've got the Ace of Wands here. If they think that they're going to get a new beginning, they're not going to get this new beginning. Then, you know, they're not going to find that passion with any, you know, with anyone for a while. You know, the passion is going to fizzle out in their life. They're going to find that nothing is... They're going to find everything so boring, so dull. You know, this is being, you know... passionate about you, like your job or going out and seeing people. You know, this is all about having fun. Then they're gonna find everything so dull is what I'm hearing. So what else? What's their karma? Five of Wands. So they're going to get a lot of backlash. I think when the truth comes out about what they did to you, and I do feel like the truth will come out, there's going to be a lot of people that are going to be turning their backs on them. There's a lot of people that are going to be verbally, the moon, verbally maybe even abusing them because it's part of the karma because they did that to you, my pile too. The moon is all about their secrets are going to start coming out. And this is like... a narcissist, basically, they put on this act that I am so wonderful. And people, when they meet a narcissist, think they're so wonderful. So when you start telling people that they've done this certain things to you or they've done this and that, people look at you like you're crazy. Like, what? No, not them. You know, no, they're lovely. And that's the thing about narcissists. They don't like to be disliked. So they put on this Mr. Wonderful or Mrs. Wonderful. You know, if you know anything about narcissism, which I've done a lot of reading up about that, this is what's starting to be revealed to people. They're going to start seeing that it was just an illusion, it was just what they wanted people to see, and this is part of their karma as well. Tell me more about the karma for this person, spirit, please. What's their karma? Look at this as well. Five of Emotions. They're going to be grieving over losing you. That I think they felt like they had you in a place that you would never ever leave them. You know, they were that cocky about it. So now they're the ones that are grieving over losing you. We have, you know, leave that one. So we have the High Priestess, we have the Six of Voices, which is the Six of Swords, and the Three of Swords. Yeah, look at this. This is, I'm picking up from the High Priestess, this is your angels and ancestors and your spirit guides are finally coming to take over because of what's happened. And this is their way, I mean, this could even be their spirit guides that are punishing them for what they did to you, you know, because you're a good soul, you know, you're a good person. And this is someone that you know, the High Priestess is a secret keeper, but she's about to reveal all this person's secrets. This is their karma for this. You know, moving from rough waters to calmer waters. But no, this ain't going to happen for them. They're going to keep going through the rough waters till they learn their lessons. This makes me laugh, this card, actually, because... You know, look at you here, and you've got this little person standing on the edge of their finger. It's like you are this, you've risen above this. You are the bigger person, you know. You are someone that is spiritually protected, you know. You're looked after, and there's this little person right here. You see them as being someone that is little now. And they don't like this. This is part of their karma. And I feel like people are going to start looking down on this this energy here. And they don't like that. You've got the Three of Voices, which is heartbreak. They're going to feel this breakup, this ending of this relationship here. They're going to feel it so... Ow. Ooh. Arsehole. Just got a sharp pain in my bloody arm. And we'll continue to talk. So yeah, as I was saying, they're going to be feeling the pain of losing you. You know, this can be a third party. So it could be that you do leave this person, you know, this energy that comes forward to help you. You may end up just leaving them for them. You know, they give you the push, the shove that you need to leave this energy here, my pile too. I'm gonna, oh no, 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 we're not leaving it there. I'm doing my cards first. I forgot about them. So let's check, see what else their karma is. Oh, right, we'll take them, even though there's quite a lot here. They're never gonna get married. So for some of you, if you were married, they're never gonna remarry. Reputation will be ruined, which I've already said. And I can't freaking see this while writing yellow. I don't know. Oh, bad skin or acne. So this stress could end up affecting their skin if they've got really nice skin. And don't forget, this can be male or female, guys. So no help from others. Yet people are going to be turning their backs on them. This is what I said with the five of wands there. They're going to end up in toxic relationships where they're going to end up being maybe gaslighted or, you know, mistreated. This is part of their karma. Good. Sorry, I don't usually wish anything bad on people, but this energy is really horrible. I'm sorry that you've had to deal with this. Reputation in ruins, we've already said that. Will age quickly. So I think maybe if they start drinking, you know, or doing things that they shouldn't be doing, they're going to age very quickly. No blessings from the divine. So yeah, their spirit guides could be blocking them because of what they did to you, you know. Like I said, I feel like you're spiritually protected, you know. Disappointment after disappointment. Will not be able to manifest anything, and they will get fired from their job. So yeah, they could end up losing their job. So that's a lot of karma for someone here, guys. So I'm gonna leave it there, pile two, and you look after yourselves, okay? See you soon, bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose events, which is milestone, so from what I'm picking up from this energy, so we're gonna look at the person's energy or people's energy, and then go from the karma after I've found out what's going on. So for you guys that chose this card, it could be that you've either celebrated a wedding anniversary with this person, or it could even be that you've celebrated something that you were working hard on with someone else, you know, and you got awards for this. It could be, you know, maybe charity or something like that, but I'm picking up more like weddings, wedding anniversary, or just anniversaries, even if you're not, what, you know, not married. So let's have a look at this energy here. Tell me more, spirit, please, about this milestone. My pile three. Yeah, look at this. So you've got Page of Swords, Three of Cups. So this is a celebration. It's a wedding. It's anniversaries. It's, you know, births. It can be like christenings, but I'm picking up a wedding anniversary, or now I'm picking up, it's very strong. So you've celebrated something, which clarifies that card there. I love when spirit does that, thank you spirit. But there's gossip surrounding you at the moment, or this person. There's some spying going on as well. So this, whoever this is spying on your social media. They're trying to keep an eye on you. Tell me more. And something here, like there was a choice that was made, or, you know, you've got other, it could be that you had other options or they had other options, but I'm trying to find out more about their energy. So let me take this. So we have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have the moon here. Pisces energy as well. Okay. Look, the moon's all about illusions. It's all about secrets. Things not, you know, things being kept in the dark. Things that you are not aware of. Now, with the Seven of Cups to come out with the moon, it's telling me that this energy here had other options. You know, there could have been multiple options. But let's have a look, guys. And if... No, that's too many. But tell me about the Seven of Cups. Tell me... Hang on, guys. This bendy cards. I hate bendy cards. Tell me about the Seven of Cups. Okay, can't shuffle. Tell me about Seven of Cups, please, spirit. Oh, okay. Now, sometimes with the Ace of Wands, okay, Justice, Karma, Libra, love it. This is what we're doing, a karma reading. Now, if it's too upsetting for you guys, because I don't beat around the bush, I love to just be honest in a reading, because what's the point in doing a bloody reading, isn't it? So if it's too upsetting, please don't stay and watch, okay? Don't want to upset anybody. So when I see this card, the Ace of Wands, it's about a passionate new beginning. So I'm looking at several different scenarios here with this energy that's come through. Now, they had other options. This is also a celebration card. Yes, you may have celebrated an anniversary or a marriage or, you know, what have you. I also see it as a third party. Now, this to come out with this, I'm looking at more of a third party or multiple parties. Now, this person likes to think with their wand. You know, if you're female as well, if they're female as well, it's the same sort of thing, you know, because I see this as a, you know. So, yeah, I feel like they are driven by what's in their pants than their brain. And I think this is what's come out here that you are, you know, you just became aware of. For some of you, it may have even come out on your celebrate, like when you celebrated this, you may have found this out, which if that happened to you, I'm really sorry for you. That's awful. Now, we've got justice here. It's the karmic card. It's all about fairness. It's all about you discovering the truth, you deciding what's good for you. It's also the truth that came out, and you may have taken back your power, you know. You may have decided, well, I'm not putting up with this, you know. Tell me more about the Seven of Cups and the Three of Cups. Tell me more about the Seven of Cups and the Three of Cups. Yeah, look. You were blinded to this. You didn't see what was going on in front of you. You really did not. It's like you couldn't believe that this person would actually do this to you. You know, maybe you had a feeling about it and you just didn't want to believe it, you know. But though that blindfold there has come off now, or is coming off. You know, it could be that you've got this celebration coming up, and I, you know, and if that's the case, you know, this may be revealed just before it. It may be revealed while you're there. So, you know, take what resonates. Tell me more about this Seven of Cups, please, Spirit. And if you're going to hear whining in the background, that's my dog outside the door whining to come in. She's such a noob. Right, Cups. Five of Cups and the Ten of Wands. Knight of Swords. Now, this person was reckless in what they did. You know, it could have been a one-off thing that they just got carried away with it and was reckless. And they've literally brought about a big change to your life, you know, a big drastic change to your life. And now you're left in this state of the Five of Cups, which is grieving for what you had, you know, grieving for the loss of what you thought you had. And this has brought about a lot of burdens. You know, you're carrying around this weight on your shoulders. You know, it's affected you quite deeply. Well, why wouldn't it? Why would it not? Tell us more about this situation, please, Spirit. Tell me more about this energy here. Yeah, look, Three of Pentacles as well. So they could have met this person at work. You know, they could have worked with this person. We've got Aquarius energy there as well. We've got Temperance, which is Sagittarius energy. We've got Earth sign, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well here. Now, it could have been someone that they were working with. It could have been an affair at work, you know. Sorry, my dog's put me off. You know, Temperance is all about success and harmony. You know, this is, you had a lovely relationship here with the King of Pentacles. You know, the King of Pentacles is someone's husband, someone's wife, you know, because they're energies, guys. So, you know, this person, this King of Pentacles, you know, was a caregiver. You know, they looked after their family. They did well in business. And this is why I'm saying I feel like they met this person at work. This was like a work affair. And you know, and the King of Pentacles can be seen as someone that's unfaithful. I just want something. I keep getting drawn. It's like I'm stoning out towards my cards over here for you guys, and these were not going to be used. Tell me more about this situation here. I'm going to grab you guys a special, my pile phrase. Tell me more about this King of Pentacles here. What's really going on, Spirit? Tell me about the King of Pentacles. Oh, bloody hell. Okay. On the back of the deck, we have the Rival. Strong influences on your person. Your person is choosing the Rival. Rival dominating situation. So what I am picking up here is I believe that they have left you for this third party here. But I feel like you either celebrated your anniversary and then they told you, or your anniversary is coming up. That's why it's so hurtful at the moment. So the Rival's got this strong influence, this strong hold over this King of Pentacles here. But then again, I don't believe that. If you don't, you know, no one makes you do anything, okay? All these excuses about, oh, you know, I didn't know what I was doing, oh, it's their fault, blah, 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 whatever. Almost there. Answers are close. Don't give up. A new beginning is close. So I feel like for some of you, if you don't know the truth or you don't know what really happened, you know, and they're not really wanting to tell you what's going on, maybe they just up and left you. Spirit is saying to you, look, the door's open, you know, things are going to be illuminated soon, you know, don't give up, the answers are close. Then you've got playing dumb. This is what I just said. Pretending not to know the truth, doing anything to avoid the change, avoid responsibility. And this is what I said, I feel like you're being gaslighted as well. It's like, you know, that could be why the Two of Swords is there as well, is because they're trying to convince you that you're crazy, you know, the gaslighting thing. So it's like, you know, what are you on about? You know, no, that didn't happen. No, you know, you're hearing wrong. Gaslighting, basically. So they're playing dumb. You know, maybe you've asked them, is there someone else? Back and forth, on and off relationship, back and forth between partners. Can't make a decision, right? So you're dealing with someone here that could be dealing with both of you at the moment. You know, don't know, they want their cake and eat it, they don't know what they want, they're confused, but the Rival is a big influence in this, you know, in the way they think. So tell me a bit more, tell me about this Five of Cups here. Fed up. The feminine had enough, choosing to find someone better, cutting their losses. But it came out like this, and you're the divine feminine. Don't forget, you can be male as well. You are not ready to cut your losses yet. You're not ready to let go of this. So I do feel like there's two of you fighting over this one energy at the moment. It's like you've invested so much time into this relationship, and it's like you want to fight for your relationship, and there's nothing wrong with that. Look, you've got the divine feminine, divine masculine here. In full control of the situation, decisive in his actions, hard to emotionally manipulate. So this is the thing, he or she, energies, but it's a he card, sometimes he, has the upper hand here. He holds all the cards. He decides whether he wants to be with you, whether he wants to be with the other person. It's like a control game. It's a controlling thing. This is like the thing about the Emperor. They like control. Look what's come out again, guys. The Rival. The Rival is the one I do believe that's actually more in control than anybody else here. I'm going to get a few more and then go back to the Tarot. Okay, look, you want to come out. Deeply regret their actions, feeling guilty for cheating, trying not to hurt anyone, right? So this could be that they're stuck in the middle because they've hurt you, but they've hurt the other person. But this is where I get really angry about this. Why should it be the other person that you're thinking about it should be your one and only, the person that you married, the person that you're in a commitment with. What about the, you know, your feelings, pole three? Ghosting, avoiding confrontation, stringing you along as a plan A and plan B, emotionally immature. And this is what I'm saying, they're playing games here, they're stringing, you know, they could be just giving you false hope here, guys. It could be that they're not actually wanting to be with you, and you know that they feel really bad. I mean, do you really want to be with someone that who feels bad for you? An arsehole. Tell me a bit more, spirit, please. Oh my god, the rival. Three times, guys, you have someone. You have someone that is the other woman or the other man, the third party, is the problem here. She, because it's a she card, guys, has got their claws into the masculine here, and it's like she's not letting go. I look at her like she's like Jezebel. So tell me more about this rival. There's something about this rival spirit. Tell me more about the rival here, because it's come out three times. Moon again. Wow, thanks, spirit. So for some of you, you may not even know about her or him. You know, it may be that I've done this reading and you've come across it and you think, you know, you've had your suspicions, but it's not been, you know, clarified yet. But like spirit says, the truth is going to be coming out soon. And this is all about the moon. It's like Pisces energy. It's truths being, you know, secrets, truths being kept in the dark, you know, illusions. It's like you're not being told the truth, or you're not seeing the truth. Look at this, the lovers. It's another person here. There's another option here. They're dealing with two people, which is the rival. Tell me more about the rival, spirit. I mean, there aren't missing me cards, but anyway. Tell me more about the rival. Page of Wands is someone that is... Right, guys, okay. If you do not know, right, this is a warning to some of you lot, and just be prepared. You're going to receive a message from the rival, because I think she's going to get to the point of, because the masculine's playing games and most probably hasn't told you about her, and I'm saying her again because it's a she card, she's actually going to message you. So she's coming up with a plan. She's coming up with an idea on how to do it. So expect a phone call. Okay, but there's something that when she communicates or he communicates, it's like an illusion. It's not, you're not being told everything here. Tell me about, look at this divine masculine again. So she is going to phone you regarding the divine masculine here. She is going to be telling you about what has been going on, because she's left it in his hands, he or she's hands, to deal with this. But because they're not dealing with this, she's taking it upon herself to actually come forward and talk to you about this, you know, tell you the truth. Tell me about the moon. This is messy. Yeah, look, player. She's right. What she's going to communicate to you guys is that, right, let me talk about that first, because I'm getting, like, you know, I'm seeing everything coming at me here. So what this person is going to energy is going to communicate to you is that your partner is a player. Your partner has been dipping their wand in somebody else, basically, because the Knight of Wands is player energy. It's someone that's in and out, that doesn't have staying power, that's not faithful, that, you know, cannot be loyal. So this is what she is going to communicate to you. She's also going to communicate to you. So this could be someone that they've had a past relationship with. It's someone from their past that they've reconciled. So they could have reconciled online, you know. Oh, my God. So what else is she going to tell you? She's going to tell you that he or she, Divine Masculine, felt bored, felt rejected by you. So this is where the gaslighting comes in. that this energy here is going to make you feel crap about yourself. She's going to be telling you things like, oh, you know, he's with me because he was bored, dissatisfied with you, you know, you brought nothing to the relationship, you know, and she's going to make you feel so shit about yourself. But do not let her do this. This is a manipulation tactic on her part. So, you know, tell me more about this rival. The rival and the divine masculine, actually. Page of Pentacles, yeah. A message, this strongly coming up with message here. Look, working on an idea in the background, working, planning, plotting is what I'm seeing to get her way. I feel it's because this masculine does not want to leave you, can't make a decision. She's doing it for him, basically. So, any more, please, Spirit? Yeah, third party. This is going to break your heart when you do find out this is someone that you've dealt with. That this rival here and your divine masculine are two reckless people that don't think about anybody else. They don't care whether they disrupt your life. They do not care as long as they get what they want. And when you find out this information here, Pile 3, you are going to have your whole world turned upside down. This is coming towards you here. It's going to bring a big change, and it involves a third party. It also involves heartache. It can involve an end of a relationship, you know, a marriage. Tell me about the Three of Swords. There it is again. They're dealing with someone from their past, someone that they've got a history with, and this is the Queen of Cups, who this rival is. Water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. This is someone from their past that they're dealing with. And they've reconciled with them, you know, they've had a reconciliation with one another. This is energy here. This rival is spiteful, so be warned. She's malicious as well. And she's very manipulative as well. So if she doesn't get what she wants, she'll sulk with the divine masculine. She'll literally sulk, and she's very controlling as well. She likes to control the situation. I think this is why she's doing what she's doing. Tell me about the Six of Cups. On the back of the deck, Ace of Swords, Spirit is saying what I've just said is the truth, and the truth is going to come out. The truth is going to be revealed to you. Why is it... Oh, this is really sad, you know, look, death. And when the truth is revealed to you, guys, my Pile 3s, it's going to bring an ending, you know. You're going to end it. You're going to move on. You're going to be single. You know, you're going to be enjoying your time when you're single. You know, you're going to be successful. You're going to be doing all right, guys. You know, you're going to be loving life. You know, it's going to be hard at first, which, you know, all breakups are. And what's really sad here is, you built a life with this person, you know, you built a ten of pentacles with them. You could have children with them. You've got a home, you've got a family, you know, there's a lot of there's money involved here. Maybe that's why this masculine does not want to let you go, because their finances are going to be affected in the divorce or the separation here. So let's get their karma now. What's the karma for... These both energies, actually, not just for the masculine here, for the actual rival here as well, because you've got two energies come out. Actually, the rival dominated your reading, guys. It's like he or she took over your the reading. So the karma for these two is that I love it. How can I explain this? The rival is possessive, okay? The rival does not want to let the masculine go. So even though I see these two, the karma for these two is that it is going to come to an end. The karma is that you are going to leave them. You're going to close the chapter. That's their karma. The karma for them too as well is that I think the divine masculine here is going to actually leave them. Okay, the rival. Now, the rival is that possessive, is exactly what I said about the Queen of Cups. She's not going to want to let go. She's holding on very tightly. She feels like she owns the masculine, basically. So this is not going to last long. I think once all this comes out and the sneaking around or what have you, the novelty of it all, the excitement of it all is going to wear off. It's going to be over. But the rival's not going to want to let go. And the karma is here is that it's going to end and that she can't let go. And then she's obviously acting all possessive and, I'm picking up like stalking as well. I know I shouldn't laugh, but I think that's the masculine's karma here as well. So tell me more about the karma for the rival and the masculine spirit. Actually, that feeling, I want that. Oh, okay. That's why that's filling my hand like that. Coldness. Their karma is a lot of people are going to turn cold towards these two, A lot of people are not going to, they're going to be keeping them at arm's length. They don't really want anything to do with them. But I'm also picking up there's going to be coldness, They're both going to turn cold, or the masculine's going to turn cold on the rival here, But you've also got the devil here. This relationship is going to turn toxic. This is their karma. This is two people that. I shouldn't laugh. The karma is the masculine is going to end up with someone that is, they chose someone that is toxic, someone that is low vibrational. They're both low vibrational anyway, the pair of them. So basically, the pair of them here is, she likes control. She wants to control everything. She doesn't want to let go. She's holding on to this energy here, like this male here. So this is two people that are in a toxic situation. The relationship is going to turn toxic, but even afterwards, it's still going to be toxic. It's like he can, the masculine cannot. And like I said, even if you're female, like they're female, you turn it around the energies, guys. But I'm just using it as the character on the card. So even though the masculine wants to get away from her, he can't get away from her. It's like they're chained together, basically. And this is their karma here. It's like you chose wrong and now you've got to deal with this. So tell me more about the karma for these two energies here, for the rival and for the masculine. Tell me the karma. Oh, there it is again. It's like the fourth time. Karma for these two is that because they brought about a big disruption in your life and a big change, and they were so impulsive, your masculine may have been so impulsive in getting involved with this person, and they were so reckless, they're going to be suffering the consequences for this. The big change is not going to be a big change for the good, it's going to be a big change for the worse. Work came out like this, working hard. Working hard on a relationship, working hard on business, on work and what have you, but coming out like that, the karma is that the masculine does not want to work hard on this anymore. They don't want to invest in this anymore. And it could be that their finances, like their business, is going to be affected. The hangman. This is them being at a standstill. This is them not moving forward in life. Nothing's going their way. It's like basically they've wasted their time and energy. The masculine's literally wasted their time with the rival here. Yeah, look, here we go. The Queen of Wands is seen as the other woman or the other man because their energies, They use their sex appeal to get what they want. They use their body to get what they want. And I feel like the karma here is that's not going to work anymore. So any more karma here for the person? Hurt the pile phrase. Oh my God. We've got the lovers. We've got the wands, six of wands, eight of swords, knight of cups, cups, eight of wands. Yeah. So the karma for these two is that the karma is the masculine chose wrong. They thought they were going to be victorious, but they're not. There's no victory in this connection here that they chose, this other lover that they chose here. They're not victorious or whatever it is, at all. If anything, it put them in a trapped situation. Like they feel trapped. They don't know how to get out of it. And this is what I think, they tried to get out of it, but it was too late because it was revealed to you, because the rival took it into their own hands and revealed it to you, you know. So now they're in this mental prison and having to deal with this situation with the rival, the mess that they've caused. So this is their karma here. They thought they were going to be clever and get away with having another person on the side, but that's not the case. They literally, the truth came out here, and that's the karma for them. The karma is as well, this person's going to try and manipulate you, try and sweet talk you, try and woo you again, maybe like offer to take you out, try and start again, you know, and they want to propose this to you, they want to, you know, but you don't trust them no more. And the karma is here, you're walking away, you are done, you have left this behind. You're like, nope, I'm being single, and that's their karma. You're looking after number one now. So, yeah, they're going to come to you with a proposal here to start again. You know, here's the message card here. Things, messages coming out of, like, nowhere. Communication, very swift communication as well. But you're going to communicate to them that you're done. And that's the karma, karmic justice here. Let's get some of my cards here for these two. So what's the karma for these two energies here, Spirit? What's karma? These two energies here. Okay. We have blocked finances, so their finances is going to be affected. We will not be able to connect to anyone emotionally. Yeah, so because I know this sounds really horrible, Pile 3. I do feel like it was more sex because the Devil card was there as well. So like they were addicted to each other because of the physical, you know, thing was really good and they were passionate about it and what have you. But there's no emotional connection with this person, with this rival. And the karma here is, for the masculine, is that they're not going to be able to find that emotional connection with anybody else. You know, they had that with you. STDs, STIs, so, you know, that's part of their karma. They will go grey very quickly, so it could be the rival that goes grey quickly, or even the masculine. People will talk crap about them, so there's a lot of gossip surrounding them. Let's get a bit more. What's the karma for my pile freeze? Oh, gold. No equal give and take. So yeah, whoever they get involved with, or if they're still involved with this energy here, the rival over there, there's going to be no equal give and take. They're going to literally, the person's just going to take. They're going to be used, basically. No success in anything, so anything they want to do, there's going to be no success. No genuine friends around them. I think they're going to lose all their friends. Look at this on the back of the deck as well, they've got abandonment here. So I do feel like a lot of people are going to abandon this masculine here for what they've done to you guys. Will not be able to manifest anything. So yeah, I think their spirit guide's got, you know, maybe the universe got them on block at the moment because of their behavior. They're gonna have nightmares, you know, they could be haunted by what they did to you, you know, the guilt. Surprised actually the Nine of Swords didn't come out, because that's usually like, you know, having nightmares about what you did, you know, suffering the guilt. So let's get a couple more before I close it. They're not going to be desired. They will never find real love in this lifetime. Yeah, because I do believe that you were their real love, but they didn't see it, they didn't appreciate it, and it will come out of nowhere as part of their karma that they messed up big time by losing you. They're going to end up in toxic relationships. So I'm going to leave it there, my pile freeze. I hope this resonated, and if it did, please hit like, and I'll see you soon. Bye.